WMMS.
Reading a fascinating article on cows this morning. You ever read about cows, Bill?
Nah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
You ever stumble across any bovine literature and then you just get sucked in?
No.
Well, I read enough for the both of us.
Okay. Sure you do.
Hey, listen. You know, these researchers are out there trying to do good work. And if it's one thing if people say, I don't want to eat cows. It's an understandable way to approach your life. Some people are opposed to consuming these animals. Fewer people are trying to focus on understanding these animals, right? And so there are some researchers who are trying to inspire farmers to kind of zero in on the emotional state of their cattle. You know, our customers who might live in more rural areas in Northeast Ohio. If you know farmers, you know, some of them get a little rough with their stock. And you hate to see that. You hate to see a guy who's frustrated. Hey, maybe hits a pig over the head with a shovel.
Yeah, that's not cool.
At the very least, that's not cool. But they're trying to. They found that cows all have unique moos to express their feelings. Right? If you're a Friends fan, remember the show Friends? And Joey would say, the point is moo. It's what a cow thinks. He didn't know what moot meant. He said, the point is moo. Right.
stupid.
It's very stupid. But they're kind of coming around to that.
Sounds like something I would say.
That's a moo point.
That's right. The point is moo.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're studying these cows.
Girlfriend, what is an appropriate amount of time to wait before you make a move?
Oh, I'd say about a month.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I'd say 3 to 4.
Half hour.
Interesting. When it's your assistant, I would say never.
All right, Rach, the big question is, does he like you? Right? Because if he doesn't like you, this is all a moo point.
Huh. A moo point?
Yeah. It's like a cow's opinion. It just doesn't matter.
Yep. A cow's opinion doesn't matter.
I'm Joey, and I'm disgusting.
These people are saying that, listen, a cow's opinion does matter.
No, I miss Friends.
You miss Friends.
It was on
Netflix.
It's on
all the time.
It's not on Netflix. I don't watch TV the way you watch TV.
No. I mean, isn't it still on Netflix?
No, it's gone.
Oh. And my daughter got way into it, too. Where'd it go? Oh, it's going to HBO Max, isn't it?
It's going to HBO Max, yeah.
When's that popping up?
I don't know.
April?
Not soon enough. I need some Joey in my life.
You mean you were that into Friends in pre-streaming age you didn't have Friends DVDs?
I did have. I bought all the Friends DVDs when I lived in the Philippines.
Where are they?
They are gone.
Oh.
I got rid of all my DVDs.
Did you trade them to stow away out of the country?
No, they were very illegally made. So I had them all, but they weren't proper DVDs. And
I see.
Couldn't resell them or anything.
The show was called Pals. Yeah. So,
and
you know.
I have a non-region DVD player to watch them.
You didn't have one. Or you did have one.
I had to have a special DVD player.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Hey, you were dancing on the edge down there, weren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a bootlegger, Jerry.
Yeah, I'm a bootlegger. Is that your orthopedic pillow? Maybe. Well, is it? So cows and their unique moos. Something to think about. I don't know. And extra exciting if you're somebody who really, really likes to eat meat. Because you don't care at all, right?
Yeah,
you're like, hey, find out what this thing's moo sounded like and bring it out here. I want a 48-ounce porterhouse.
Keep it moving.
Moving along.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Imagine, I'm always fascinated by the people who seek this work out. These people who are agricultural researchers or whatever, you know, and they're like, oh, I'm out here just, you know, registering calls on the Holstein Friesian scale or whatever. Stuff you want to do. I don't know. I got nothing for it.
Milking this moment.
Huh?
No, it was.
Shut up, Poundcake.
Go dance in the dark.
When I grow up, I'm going to Bovine University. God, we binged The Simpsons this weekend when everyone in when my girls were sick. Nora's puking, Gwen's puking. So I'm taking care of them, binging The Simpsons. And I admittedly came to The Simpsons late. I had one friend. He's still one of my best friends. My only friend left from high school. And he was with The Simpsons day one. Right?
That was me.
I found it way too rudimentary. It didn't jive with me. So I got into The Simpsons probably like season six. But I didn't realize how many episodes I've seen over the years. And granted, it's on all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You can watch every episode now on Disney Plus. And we were just going through. And I'm sitting there crying at the Lisa is a Vegetarian episode.
It's an incredible
like
episode.
Like I always do. And I go, okay, I've seen this 100 times. You know, here's the food chain. And it's, you know, the
all pointing back to the...
The hawk takes a sheep.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then the shark eats a gorilla out of a tree. And I go, you know...
Just the way that one starts with Troy McClure walking across the cows.
Yeah.
And then he jumps down off of them.
Yeah.
They're all just packed into this pen, and he's just walking on their backs.
Yeah. Come, Timmy, let's go to the killing floor. And the kid goes, what? That's really more of a grate.
It's really more of a grate where the items can sluice through.
And then you just see the cows going up and you hear like crunching, mooing noises.
Oh, no.
And then it's a conveyor belt of steaks that fall into a truck. Meat for you is what the truck says. And I swear to God, I'm like, I won't.
And they fixed the aspect ratio on them now, right?
I'm not that nerdy about it, but I remember them mentioning that. Yeah,
I thought they were going to do that at the beginning of this year, so I think it might. I haven't watched Simpsons in a couple weeks, so I need to get back on there because I was going through all like the newer ones, like I'm up to season like 22 or something, and I'm like, man, how do they keep making this show?
Yeah,
I
mean,
they're doing like side episodes, or they're doing episodes for side characters or like one-off characters, like Disco Stew.
Well, I saw that Hank Azaria said he's not going to do Apu anymore. Because he took a lot of heat for that.
Mm-hmm.
And after 30 years, he's like, we can do away. You know,
yeah.
That's fine. But Hank Azaria does the most voices on that show. He does more voices than anyone else on The Simpsons.
Very talented.
Do you get paid per voice, like per character? Or do you?
I don't think so.
Is it just in your contract, like you're going to do this?
I think
there's
a maximum amount they can do, but I'm not sure.
Probably not, but they're all so well paid.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Hank Azaria, when he came into that show, I think season two, and he wasn't a voice actor. He was just a guy trying to get some work, and he ended up being amazing on that show. But I'm sitting there watching.
Is he Principal Skinner? Or is that
Harry
Shearer?
Yeah, that's Harry Shearer, I think. But Hank does Wiggum and Apu, and I mean, a million of them. Mm-hmm. Mo. But I'm sitting there, I'm like, okay, I'm not going to laugh as hard at this as I have in the past. And I cried laughing so hard at that. Partially because you so miss Phil Hartman in that show.
Yes.
But also, it's just a perfect episode.
It's a great show.
There isn't a wasted line. There isn't, you know, Lisa, you're not going to eat bacon? No. What about ham? No. What about pork chops? Dad, those all come from the same animal. Right. A magical animal.
Mystical animal.
Magical animal. Yeah.
Just even at the beginning when they're at the petting zoo and they keep awing at the different sheep and they get down to the lamb and then the one walks back into frame and Homer goes, out of the way, you!
Hey, we get a cuter one.
Yeah.
Just ask this scientician. And the guy goes, they cut away from it.
Anyway, that's a good show.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm not going to recount the whole episode for you. And on Disney Plus, they begin each season with the Treehouse of Horror.
Well, that's how they were released for a long time.
Was it?
There's some seasons where those were the first episodes.
Of the fall?
And then some of them weren't. Because football would mess up a lot of the season premieres.
I see.
Football and baseball, I think.
Well, and you get to the later seasons, and they don't do the full intro anymore.
Mm-hmm.
They just do the couch gag.
Yeah.
And so my daughter's like, no, I want to watch the ones with the whole intro.
Mm.
So I got to go way back.
That's annoying.
And I don't want to go too far.
Then you also have the newer ones where they have a new intro. Like, I think it was after the movie came out, they created a new intro that was, like, includes a lot more characters and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, show her that one, see if she likes that.
How do you like this? Mm-hmm. I got $1,000 here for you. Chance for you to go fund yourself. You get this every hour, all day. Good luck.
Hey, it's Rover. Go fund yourself. We have your shot at $1,000 now. Text the nationwide keyword crazy to the number 200-200. You'll get a text confirming entry plus iHeartRadio info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's crazy to 200-200. Good luck and go fund yourself from 100.7 WMMS.
I'll tell you who my hero of the week is. And this might come as a shock because this is a guy who was really, he was misappropriating some funds. Mm. But I also think this has to do with a guy who, I don't think he's from here. I think he got thrust into a culture that perhaps he didn't quite understand. And this is a now former professor at Drexel University. So this is no slouch.
I don't know anything about Drexel.
Drexel is in Philadelphia.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a good school.
All right.
Yeah.
Because it sounds like one of those places that they have everywhere, like an ITT Tech or something.
Oh, no, it's not like that. Like DeVry is what you're thinking, yeah. No, Drexel's a pretty small school. It's a private school. It's probably like 15,000, 20,000 students. Chika Odinaka Nwankapa is the former professor, and he's been charged with spending his research grant money on strippers and other fun things.
Well, what was he researching?
Well, my thought was, why couldn't you just say that you were mentoring these girls who were working their way through school?
I feel like there's another way that you can justify spending the money on strippers and, you know, having fun if you're doing some sort of research, right?
Yeah, and this is what I mean. I don't know where he's from. His name sounds African or something, so maybe he is over here.
Well,
and
that's
a
straight British name.
And he's, you know, he was inundated with this money. And anyway, they gave him $200,000, the engineering department. He was the chairman of the engineering department. Smart dude in many other ways. He stole $200,000 in research grant money that had been given to his department by the Navy. And he was 57. He spent $96,000 in strip clubs.
That's so much money.
He was balling.
He's trying to see what the effect of strippers have on semen.
He wanted to go into the back room, like where no one else gets to go, and it's just like, all right, well, what happens in this room? It's just between you and me.
He got
like,
straight up Jennifer Lopez hustlered. Yeah.
Yeah, they touching your thigh, and then...
Well, let's hope he got her and not Awkwafina. Listen, so he spends $96,000 over 7 years in strip clubs. So this guy had a run. It's not like they caught him in a year. He had a pretty good time. He also spent another $89,000 on iTunes.
Oh my God.
Did
meals.
He buy all of it?
And other unauthorized expenses. The school found out when they did an audit, of course. And it showed numerous unauthorized and no receipt purchases in 2017.
He's living it up.
Imagine that you thought you'd get away with it. You're like, there's no receipts. Nobody, no crime. Yeah, the school came to him and said, the hell happened. He gave $53,000 of it to the university.
Oh, what a nice
so
guy.
So listen, there's part of him where, you know, he's... He faces 14 years in prison, right?
So he's going to take even more money.
Right.
Than he didn't earn.
Now we're going to be paying, for,
we're
this
paying
guy.
For this guy.
Oh, my God. He tried to pass off strip club expenses as catering and food costs.
Maybe it was.
Despite the fact that 48% of them were made on the weekends and 63% of them were processed between the hours of midnight and 2 a.m.
We trust Ixu. We all trust Ixu. And you spend it on some stripper? Some hussies.
If this guy had just laid out his plan a little better. You know, look, I get hungry.
Just laying down pipe instead.
I do intermittent fasting, all right? And I eat between midnight and 2 a.m.
Those are my hours.
Those are my hours.
What did he say the research was for? Like, he needed $200,000 for what was he researching?
Well,
I don't think they just shovel that out
to
you.
Okay, the engineering department, he was chairing the engineering department. $200,000 from the Navy, the Department of Energy, and the National Science Foundation. Doesn't say what the grant money was for or what he told them he was going to use it for.
But I'm guessing it had to do with engineering. Something more scientific than...
ingenuity.
Yeah, than going to strip clubs and sweatpants and getting rubbed on.
But there's so many alibis he could have... I'm creating a system of levers and pulleys with these young girls. I don't know. He's using one of them as a fulcrum.
Joke's on us. The research was for how long can I do this before I get caught? He's like, guys.
Gentlemen, my research is complete.
Exactly. Mission accomplished.
I wanted to see how long I could get away with this.
And see, you guys got me. See, you guys are spending your money wisely. See,
right.
You guys audited me. Exactly what you're supposed to do. Congratulations.
Exactly 7 years. It's a 7-year-long plan, and it came to fruition.
When you break it down into the 7 years, it's not like he was going. Like, spending $100,000 at a strip club in a year is a lot. Over 7 years, you can see how that would add up.
It didn't matter. He was making. That's enough to make it rain each time you go.
That's $1,000 a month in the strip club. Which, again, if you're a baller, that's nothing.
Right.
This guy's pushing 60.
He was trying to live his best.
He's probably not from here, and he came over. He's like, oh, my God. I mean, all these people.
See?
All these
give
people,
me this money.
They hate us, but they want to be us, Bill. That's what I'm saying.
See, Alan, this guy is getting more prison time than that girl that assisted suicide.
Yeah, I should tell you something.
Just saying. It's a... What is it, white-collar crime?
They take white-collar crime very seriously at the university level. He's looking at 14 years. He'll probably get two.
He'll serve more time than the 11 months that chick got.
Yeah, well, he murdered a lot of poonanny there.
don't mess
clubs.
With paper. You mess
That's
with
right.
paper, you get in trouble.
That's right. You'll never get in more trouble than when you're touching somebody's money, especially a university with deep pockets, although a little more shallow these
but
days.
But it's also... Not just their money.
The Navy.
Messing with the Navy.
Effing with the government.
The energy department. Like, all that stuff. Like, they're going to throw the book at him.
Yes. That's Rick Perry's money to waste.
That's
not his.
Right.
All right. Let me break here. You got something you want to get through me to text? 35192, alancoxshow.com. If you want to get the details on the Polar Blast, it's 2 weeks from tomorrow. You can join us for that. AlanCoxShow.com. Use the keyword Polar Blast.
It's the Alan Cox Show on 100.7 WMMS.